So the last theorem we're going to look at, which is actually three theorems, but they're all the same theorem. Sound confusing? Products of intercepts. It's this situation. So in this case, I've got two chords and they intersect each other. AX times BX will equal CX times DX. So the point where it cuts. The reason would be product of intercepts of intersecting chords. So when two chords intersect. But the way I tend to remember it is a little bit different. That's how I tend to remember it. The endpoint of the chord to the point of intersection times the endpoint of the chord to the point of intersection equals the endpoint of the chord to the point of intersection times the endpoint of the chord to the point of intersection. Now, it sounds a lot more complicated, but when you look at the picture, it actually makes it quite clear. The end point of the chord to the point of intersection, AX, times the end point of the chord to the point of intersection, BX, is equal to the end point of the chord to the point of intersection, CX, times the end point of the chord to the point of intersection, DX. Okay? But thinking of it that way, when I said all these theorems are the same, I can still use the same idea now, where instead of talking about intersecting chords, I'm talking about intersecting secants, because the rule is still the same. End point of the chord to the point of intersection, so it's still A to X, times the end point of the chord to the point of intersection, it's still B to X, is equal to, then we go to the other secant, end point of the chord to the point of intersection, times end point of the chord to the point of intersection. So I can still think about it the same way. The only difference here is instead of intersecting chords in my reasons, it's intersecting secants. And then there's a third one. Oh, notice, secants always intersect outside the circle. There's a third one where we have a tangent and a secant. But I can still use the same idea. The actual theorem is AX squared. But what I think about it here is instead of thinking of this as a single point, I think of it as a chord AA. And so the end point of the chord is A to the point of intersection X times the end point of the chord A to the point of intersection X is equal to the end point of the chord DX times end point of the chord CX. So all three theorems, I can think of it the same way. So whilst it sounded crazy, you know, end point of the chord, the point of the intersection times end point, the idea helps me remember all three theorems. And if I use this one, the actual reason is the square of the tangent is the product of the intercepts. So they're just three additional theorems, which can be thought of as the same theorem. 9G, so ends our little look into circle geometry.